Welcome back to Fast Money. We've got an earnings alert on Qualcomm, the chip maker, moving sharply lower after hours, down by 8%. That conference call is underway. Let's get to Josh Lipton with the details. Josh.
So, Melissa, remember heading into this print, Qualcomm had rallied about 30% over the past 3 months. It was up more than 80% over the past 12 months, but down here in the after hours, you saw them beat on the bottom line, but revenue did come in slightly below expectations. For Q2, they're looking for between $1.55 and $1.75. That's above, and they're looking on the top line for between $7.2 and $8 billion. Unclear if that's comparable to the analyst forecast, but digging into the segments, QCT, so the chipset business is $6.53 billion. QTL, the licensing business, that's $1.66 billion. CEO Steve Mollenkopf on the call, of course, he's stepping down, but on the call here, he's saying that adoption of 5G driving a multi-year transition playing to Qualcomm's strengths. Qualcomm has a strong pipeline, he says. The licensing business is unmatched. Qualcomm's outlook would have been even stronger, he says, but the company is supply constrained here. Other executives chime in saying, yes, demand is outpacing their supply. Of course, we heard this from other chip names as well. Because of the strong recovery in certain end markets, the work from home trend, execs did say they thought things could normalize in the second half of the year. I also did check in, though, with Mike Walkley over Canaccord Genuity. He covers the name. He said this was a solid print, but not what the market expected, given Apple's recent strong results. Remember, Apple's still an important customer here. The market expected a bigger beat, Mike says, than what we saw. Qualcomm didn't deliver. The QTL, so that licensing business, weaker than expected, Mike saying, likely pointing to softer sales outside of Apple, so meaning those Android phones. On a positive note, Mike did say guidance was better than consensus, strong those 5G trends. You know, the RF business, so radio frequency chips, exceeding $1 billion for the first time in a quarter, but clearly not providing much comfort, at least here in the after hours. Back to you, Melissa.
Josh, thanks. Josh Lipton. So, Dan, was it all context, the run-up going into the quarter?
I think a lot of it. I think if you look at other mega cap tech earnings, you look at how well most of them have done. I'll just make one point here, and I've been saying this on Fast Money for years. If there was ever a time for Qualcomm, which is fabulous, to merge with Intel, both have new CEOs, they could take out a ton of costs. It could be a $100 billion revenue year company, $400 billion market cap, take out. I mean, to me, it seems like such a no-brainer, especially given Intel's transition and some of the issues that they're having, and Intel's losing Apple. And we know that, obviously, like Josh just said, Qualcomm has Apple as a big customer still.
That's interesting. Although new CEOs tend to like their new jobs and not want to give up their new jobs by selling the company that they now had. Guy, I'm curious as to what your thoughts are on the quarter.
I like the fact, I mean, Dan Nathan, mergers and acquisition, man. That is fantastic.
And that was free advice, right? I mean, that's just right out there.
Free advice.
Yeah.
And you know they're both listening. So when this happens in a month from now, they'll pretend they did it on their own. It's all Dan. I thought it was a fine quarter. I mean, listen, the revenue miss upsets people. But you just start to look at the numbers. I mean, in terms of valuation, at $150, Qualcomm's trading about 18.5 times next year's numbers. That's not rich in this environment. It's not rich in the chip space. And it's certainly not rich compared to the broader S&P 500. So I think you buy it here. I understand people get caught up, oh, revenue miss, EPS in line, they weren't thrilled with the guide, but you're still talking about a company with 35% operating margins. I think it was a fine quarter. I think you buy the weakness.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.